fella, number 33, Miles Taylor. UT Martin is coached by Heath Schroyer. Assistant coaches Anthony Stewart, Jermaine Johnson, John Aiken, DeAndre Walker, and Garner Small.
Chris Brinkley with Coach Cal Luther as the Skyhawks are set to take on Eastern Illinois. And Cal, this is a very good Eastern Illinois team we're playing today.
Yes, it is. And their coach has got some great experience. He's just building a program. He's one of the ranked teams in the country for bringing in the most new players. I think they were ranked second. So he's got a brand new squad in most respects. And he's got some real talent in it. There's some talented freshman kids and some talented junior college kids in the lineup.
And Kadar Edwards going in there. Tamon Howard jumping against Petrowski in the ball. Who's got it? First possession, UT Martin has it. And the Skyhawks will have it with just under 20 minutes on the clock here. 3 seconds ticked off during that first one. Cal, you're right there on that one. And the Skyhawks inbounding it to Mon Howard, getting it to Terrence Durham. Durham over on the right side to Alex. Back to Kadar. Kadar Edwards kicks it out. Alex Anderson for three, missed it short, rattles around, no rebound. The smallest man on the floor, Cornell Johnson, gets it. And Cornell, a 5'7 guard from St. Louis, a sophomore. And a foul inside against the Skyhawks. This one goes against Tamon Howard.
Cornell may be one of the smallest guys in the league, but he's got one of the tallest haircuts in the league.
No doubt about it. That makes him a little bit taller, doesn't it? You're welcome. Cal, I got to do some housekeeping over here for just a second.
Shot by Demetrius McReynolds. That's good.
And Demetrius hits that three-pointer with the Skyhawks trailing by three. With the basketball, Terrence Durham now for UT Martin. Terrence gets it over to Alex Anderson, now to Kadar Edwards. Edwards fires and misses. Rebound coming off to Trey Anderson. Right side, Tisson. Out to Trey Anderson. To Cornell Johnston at the Elam Center, the Eastern Illinois in the road blue with the white numbers and the Skyhawks in the home white. Blue numbers trimmed in orange. McReynolds on the outside. Inside Petrowski, six on the shot clock, getting it to Johnston, who shoots the three and connects. And just like that, UT Martin is trailing 6-0.
They start right off and hit the first two shots they attempt, and they're both threes and both deep.
And the Skyhawks 0-for-2 from the field, trailing 6-0, while Eastern Illinois is 2-for-2. Bad pass, and Terrence Durham gets it near midcourt on the Skyhawk logo. Here's a screen from Miles Taylor. Terrence to Tamon Howard. Howard inside. Miles up, fouled, and fouled by Luke Petrowski. Cal, from here, that looked like pretty solid defense.
I was just going to comment. The big guy never gets a break on these deals.
Here's the replay on OVC Digital, and he was leaning forward a little bit.
A little bit was probably the important word right there.
Yeah, and Miles Taylor at the free throw line hits it, with the Skyhawks making it 6-1. And the second free throw is good, and UT Martin cuts it to 4, 6-2 now the score, with 18-18 to go. UT Martin showing the full court pressure to Eastern Illinois in backcourt. Petrowski to McReynolds. McReynolds got the hot hand against UT Martin at Lance Arena. Inside pass on the reverse is no good. Anderson misses. And the ball goes out of bounds, but a foul is called.
I think the foul was on Kadar.
Kadar with a foul. Here's a baseline shot that's up and no good. And a foul on the rebound going against McReynolds. Stopping the clock with 18:03 to go in the first. That's the team's second foul. Tamon Howard will inbound it in backcourt, getting it to Terrence Durham. Durham guarded by Cornell Johnston. couple three-pointers, and Eastern Illinois has a four-point lead early in this one. Miles Taylor puts down the dribble, takes it right to Petrowski and scores, and the Skyhawks cut it to two.
That's a tough matchup for Petrowski. He's 6'11".
Yeah, Miles is a little bit undersized in there, but has some quickness at 6'7". And he's gotten all four of UT Martin's points here in the early going. Anderson facing the basket from the free throw line. Fadeaway over Miles is no good. Rebound UT Martin's to Mond Howard. Outlet to Durham. Durham getting it to Kadar Edwards. Edwards on the left wing. Throws it inside to Miles Taylor. Taylor kicks it out. Terrence Durham fires a three. Straight away good. And UT Martin has taken the lead now at 7-6. Turnover, Eastern Illinois fighting to press, and an offensive foul on Cornell Johnston. What did he do, Cal?
He got his arm out ahead and pushed off on him.
Dribbling with one hand, pushing off with the other.
That's right.
And the Skyhawks will have the ball here with a one-point lead. Terrence Durham on the left wing. And another whistle blown. This away from the ball. It goes against the Skyhawks. Kadar Edwards with the foul. With 17 exactly remaining, and Richard Lee comes in for Kadar Edwards. Lee, the sophomore from Lake Worth, Florida, really got off to a hot start to begin the season. Has seen his minutes limited of late, averaging 6.6 per game.
We've got six fouls on the board already now for just 3 minutes of play.
Yeah, each team with three. Cornell Johnston trapped in the corner. Eastern Illinois gives it up. Back out to McReynolds. Over to Johnston. Fires it and misses. Rebound, Miles Taylor. McReynolds tried to knock it away, but Miles held on to it. Outlet to Tamon Howard. Three-pointer is no good. Rebound, McReynolds. Eastern Illinois back with the basketball. Outside Johnston calling out the play. Over to Tisson. Now McReynolds shoots the three and misses everything. Rebound, Alex Anderson. And Eastern Illinois cooling off from the field now, just 2 of 7 after hitting their first two shots. Richard Lee for three. It rattles around and doesn't go. Falls off the iron, and Eastern Illinois back with it. 16:07 remaining here. Johnston to Anderson. Left side to Son. Johnston on the right wing. Inside Petrowski. Miles Taylor with the steal. Saves it into Richard Lee. Skyhawks on the move. Anderson. UT Martin does not have the numbers. Eastern Illinois showing the transition defense. Coach Heath Stroyer calling out the set in backcourt there. As you hear him on a crowd mic. Miles Taylor has Petrowski on him again. Works his way inside. Kicks it back out to Terrence Durham. 9 on the shot clock. Terrence drives. Goes all the way in. Kick out to Richard Lee. Fakes the shot. 4 on the shot clock. 3. One-handed shot. Good. And the Skyhawks lead it by 3. Good patience, Cal.
That was very good. And boy, Lee made a very tough shot going directly at the goal and hit nothing but the net.
Anderson kicking it out. McReynolds shoots and hits. And it is a tie game at 9 apiece. Demetrius McReynolds, a 35% three-point shooter on the season. And he has his second three-pointer of the game. 6 points for him, and it's 9-9. Skyhawk basketball with 14:52 remaining in the first half. Terrence Durham for three. Left wing. Got it. Cal, that barely touched the net.
Yeah, that net stayed still after the ball went through.
You don't see that very often. 12-9 the score. The Skyhawks back down on defense with a three-point lead. Tisson. Now to Anderson. Here's a lob inside. Petrowski goes for the dunk and missed it. The big fella couldn't put it in. 6'11 senior. And a travel. Alex Anderson walks, and the Skyhawks are turning it over for the second time. Turnovers even at 2. We'll take a break. It's 12-9. UT Martin with a 3-point lead. Eastern Illinois with a basketball with 14:20 remaining. And we come back on the UT Martin Skyhawk Sports Network.
And another thing about the two of them is the fact that Coach Spoonhauer took over as the head coach at Nevada Las Vegas.
That's right.
And finished the season, ended up taking them to an NIT tournament.
That's right. And, of course, Coach Schroyer was an assistant at UNLV prior to coming to UT Martin. And I asked Coach Schroyer back when we played at Eastern Illinois. He goes a long way back with Coach Spoonauer. They've known each other for a long time when Heath was out west also. 12-9 the score, and the Skyhawks with the lead. Eastern Illinois with the ball. UT Martin in the defense. Johnston shoots and hits it, and he's fouled by Jacoby Mobley. Possibly a four-point play. Cal, it seems this season I've seen more four-point plays than I have seen in previous seasons. I don't know if it's just half of more games I'm watching or if it's something that's happening more this year.
Well, I'll tell you what, the three-pointer has become such a big factor in the college game, almost as big as it is in the pro game. Mm-hmm. And at this point, you're seeing a lot of very talented kids who've come up, who've had great schooling, and have spent a lot of time on the three. And you've got to guard them closely, and so you're going to get more situations where you're trying to contest the shooter and end up leaning into him.
Alex Anderson goes in and misses, and McReynolds gets the rebound. We're tied at 12 apiece. Johnston missed that free throw attempt on the four-point play. McReynolds fakes the shot from the wing, bouncing it back over to Johnston. Johnston gets it to Luke Norman, who's checked in. Norman, the senior from Freeport, Illinois. Back inside, A.J. Riley, and an offensive foul will give it to the Skyhawks. And the foul is on A.J. Riley. Let's reset the lineup now. McReynolds, Johnston, Riley, Norman, Muldoon is checked in. The Skyhawks go with Lee, Mobley, Anderson, Howard, Taylor. There's the OVC digital replay as we watch it there, and that is indeed an offensive foul. Tied at 12 apiece with 13:06 to go. The Skyhawks have the ball in the first half. Richard Lee on the wing. So it's a baseline. Miles Taylor back out to Alex Anderson. Anderson bouncing it to Tamon Howard outside the three-point line. To Richard Lee in the corner. Richard drives. One-handed teardrop shot is short. Rebound. Cornell Johnston. Johnston with his second rebound of the game. McReynolds faked the shot and then in midair threw it to Muldoon, who was going for the rebound. Tough break for Eastern Illinois.
Yes, that was a good play, actually. He did a good job of faking the shot, got up in the air, looked directly at the goal, and then passed it off. But he also faked out his teammate.
That's right. It's too good of a fake when you're faking out the teammate. 12-12, still our score, with 12 minutes, 37 seconds to go, and the Skyhawks have the ball here. Here I'm out to Miles Taylor, getting it to Mobley. Mobley. Guarded by Norman, stuttered with the ball, gets it back out to Terrence Durham. Durham to Alex Anderson, who fumbles the pass but gets it back. 9 on the shot clock. Bounce pass to Tamon Howard. Faces the basket 10 feet away. Shot is no good, but a foul is called. This one going against Trey Anderson.
This group that's on the floor right now, Chris, is switching situations that involve Miles. And that put them in a tough spot there because when they switch off, when they're bigger guy, their big kid under Piotrowski right now. When their bigger guy switches off, puts a much smaller man on him, and of course he can handle that just going away. He's very clever down in there. He'll lean into him. They've got to get up on him tight. They'll foul. I hope they stay with this group for a while.
Tamon Howard hits the free throw, and the second one is good. And the Skyhawks are up by 2. And one of the things Coach Royer said is they might put an extremely small lineup in there with 5 guys who can play on the perimeter. Here's Trey Anderson. Anderson with a kick out to Riley, and he turns it over. And for Eastern Illinois, that is their 5th turnover already. Skyhawks will have the ball.
Trey Anderson just missed getting 30 points in their last win. He had 29 in a ball game, and he's their top scorer, of right at 15 points a game.
He can play. I mean, offensively, Cal, the senior has shown the leadership for them throughout the season. Mobley getting it to Terrence Durham. Back over to Mobley. Skyhawks with a 2-point lead in the ball. Tamon Howard works his way to the basket, spins back to his left. Turnaround shot rattles out. Rebound. Miles fighting for it for Trey Anderson, and Anderson has it. Anderson down on the right wing. Explodes to the basket over Miles Taylor. The shot is no good. He made a great move, just did not finish.
Miles did a good job of influencing that shot, though.
What a play with a hop step move to the middle for Jacoby Mobley in transition. Off the glass, scores. And the Skyhawks lead it by four. UT Martin has led by as many as four, their biggest lead of the game here. And then Eastern Illinois out of the gate led by six. It's a four-point game now. And a UT Martin foul going against Mobley. Stops the clock with 11:05 to go. 16-12, the Skyhawks with a four-point lead. More coming up as you listen to UT Martin basketball on the Skyhawk Sports Network.
What was one of his only faults that I thought was he refused to prepare to play against his own defense. So the two didn't match well.
Cornell Johnston to throw it in to Trey Anderson. And 16-12, the Skyhawks with a four-point lead. Eastern Illinois with the ball. And they've made another change in the lineup. Kulikowski has checked in. Kulikowski in there for Eastern Illinois with Johnston, Muldoon, Anderson, and Norman. And another lob turnover, and Eastern Illinois just seems to be out of sync a little bit offensively, Cal. They made some passes where the players weren't
there.
Well,
you got more substitutions here. Whenever that takes place, when you have multiple substitutions early in a ball game particularly, you're going to find a little bit of that taking place, unless it's a very veteran team. And this is not a veteran team. This is one of the teams that's got more newcomers on it than anybody else in the country.
Yeah, there are three teams in the OVC. Well, several teams with just a lot of newcomers, but three at the top of the country. Inside, Terrence Durham missed the easiest shot he's had today. And then a foul goes against the Skyhawks. And Javier Martinez, who's checked in for UT Martin.
Terrence Durham was eating his Wheaties this morning. That one just went all the way past the goal.
Yeah, I mean, Terrence does not shoot a lot. As a matter of fact, comes into this game averaging under 2 points a game. As Marshawn Blackman checks in for Eastern Illinois. Johnston goes over to the sideline to get a towel. Is he still in the game? I think he's got hit in the mouth. I don't know if he's looking for blood or just... No, he's still on the floor. Is his mouth bleeding? Possibly is, or his lip. Yeah, I do see some blood on his lip. I'm surprised he's still in the game. 16-12 to score, UT Martin. Back down on defense, Eastern Illinois has it. Johnston for three, the lefty misses it strong. Rebound, Mobley gets up. Javier Martinez with the ball. Out to Tamond Howard. Tamond for three, got it. Had the arc on that one, Cal.
And yes, he did. And he loves that side of the floor.
Yeah.
He loves to shoot from that left side of the floor. He's very, very effective there.
Tamond, the reigning Ohio Valley Conference Player of the Week, the leader on this team. Skyhawks inside giving up the easy basket there. Kulikowski.
Kulikowski did a great job on the fake that time. And that allowed him to put that ball up easily.
Inside to Mon Howard. Howard taking it in with the right hand from the left side. No good. The rebound tipped a couple of times. Blackman comes out of there with it. 19-14. The UT Martin lead is at five. Eastern Illinois with the ball. Out to Johnson. One more pass down to Blackman. Back to Johnson outside the three-point line. Into Anderson. Turnaround shot from 14 is no good. Eastern Illinois got the board. Kicks it out to Johnston. Fakes the three. Back inside. Blackman finishes. Johnston with the assist.
I'll tell you, so far, their leading scorer, Anderson, just can't seem to get off the block. He hasn't scratched yet.
That's right. No points in the game. 0 for 4 from the field. The Skyhawks have it. UT Martin needs to take advantage of that with him off of his A game right now. Because that'll turn around before this is over. He'll find a streak where he finds points. Javier Martinez to UT Martin's Alex Anderson. Anderson behind the three-point line. Just fires it up there. It's good. That did not look like a good shot, but he hits it.
I don't know how he got that shot off. It looked like the defensive man had his hand right in the path of the ball.
Anderson now in pain. Goes out. And A.J. Riley checks in. Not really sure what's wrong with Anderson. He goes all the way to the end of the bench there with the trainer. Bent over with his hands on his knees. Just might have got hit in the sensitive area there. Not sure. Clock stopped with 8:16 to go in the half.
For me, that would have been anywhere.
That's right. And I think that Johnston's still dealing with a lip bleed. They're having all kinds. They're the walking wounded over there. Johnston with the trainer, and they got two of the starters are over there with the trainer.
As my military coach said after a half where we had four guys hurt, he said, "Gentlemen, we need to regroup and count casualties."
22-16 the score. That may be the quote of the day right there, Cal. Eastern Illinois has it down by six. Now Johnston's back on the floor despite the issue. Eight on the shot clock with his injury. Out to Tissot, who shoots a three and hits. And the Skyhawk lead is trimmed to three.
Thiessen is the shooter, the last shooter, their three-point shooter, hit that basket. Thiessen is working to try to become the record holder for the freshman to get the most three-point goals in a season.
Johnston for Eastern Illinois kicks it over. Now they get it out to Thiessen, and the shot is no good. Rebound out of bounds, and that is Eastern Illinois basketball. Timeout. We'll take a timeout with 7 minutes, 20 seconds remaining. The Skyhawks 22, Eastern Illinois 19. UT Martin down by, or UT Martin is up by three with 7:20 to go in the first. And Thiessen hits that three, and it is a tie ball game at 22 apiece.
Well, Thiessen didn't waste much time in working on trying to tie that freshman three-point record.
6 minutes, 59 seconds remaining in the half, and we're tied at 22 all. Inside, Miles Taylor off balance, misses it, gets his rebound, goes back up off balance again, and hits it. The Skyhawks lead by two.
The minute they put Piotrowski back in the ballgame, he scores.
Eastern Illinois has it. Johnston at the top of the key. Goes over to the left wing. McReynolds back to Johnston. They work it inside to Petrowski. Petrowski backing down Miles Taylor. Turn around right hook shot short. Rebound Miles Taylor. And Petrowski made a good move but missed it short. Skyhawks with the ball and a two-point lead.
That shows the difference between the styles of Miles and Petrowski. Petrowski shot a fadeaway hook. Mm-hmm. Miles will take it right at him and get him to the free throw line.
Miles has taken more free throws than any player in the history of UT Martin basketball. Missed three-pointer by Mobley. Eastern Illinois with a rebound. Skyhawks with a two-point lead. EIU with the ball. And an offensive foul, a late whistle there as Mobley was backpedaling and A.J. Riley ran into him.
Thiessen was wide open here at the top of the circle, and he was signaling for the ball. And after the charge was called, you know, he turned to the coach and gave him that look like, if he'd have passed it to me, you know, we'd have had three.
Replay, Cal, it could have been a travel also, even after the offensive foul. 24-22 the score. Skyhawks have it with a two-point lead. UT Martin in this one led by the 6 points from Durham and Miles Taylor. And Reynolds has six, Johnston has six, Thiessen has six. With Miles Taylor out to Durham for three, another one. Missed that one after hitting two earlier in the game. Rebound foul against the Skyhawks, and that is bonus time now. That's the seventh team foul against UT Martin. And Eastern Illinois also with six team fouls, so we'll have free throws for the remainder of the half.
I'm not certain, but I think it was on Durham.
It was on Chandler Rowe. I missed that one. I thought it was on Terrence, too. Chandler Rowe picks up the foul. At the free throw line, Anderson up and in. Cuts it to one. Kadar Edwards, who picked up an early foul and went out of the game, comes back in. Richard Lee goes out. Let's reset the lineup now. It is McReynolds, Johnston, Thiessen, Anderson, and Kulikowski for Eastern Illinois. UT Martin will get Tamon Howard in the game, and then we'll set the lineup. Free throws good, tie ball game again.
5 minutes to go to the half. Well, Anderson gets his first points of the game.
That's surprising. As you said, leading their team in scoring at just under 15 a game. Now Tamon Howard, Terrence Durham, Miles Taylor, Kadar Edwards, and Alex Anderson in for the spelling. So you have Alex Anderson for UT Martin, Trey Anderson for Eastern Illinois. And Kadar Edwards with a bad pass, turning it over. Skyhawks with their third miscue of the game with the turnovers. Outside Tisson, throws it to Anderson, back out Tisson. Now McReynolds, left side Johnston, whips it to Tisson, inside Anderson. Got a lane to the basket, kicks it back out. Johnston over to Anderson for three, no good. And Kadar Edwards with a rebound. Kadar throwing it to Alex Anderson. Skyhawks will slow it down. Back to Kadar Edwards. Back to Anderson. 4 minutes, 46 seconds to go in the half. It's 24-24. It was a close game at Eastern Illinois earlier this year. Miles Taylor on the help defense has his pocket picked. Johnston has it, who's speedy. Now to Anderson. Anderson lays it up and in and scores. And UT Martin is down by two.
Anderson recovered from that little tender injury he had there earlier and really showed some speed going down the floor right then.
Both Anderson and Johnston back in the game after being injured earlier. Alex Anderson almost turns it over and does. Tie ball. Eastern Illinois with it. So in this little stretch here, Cal, the Skyhawks have gotten careless with the basketball.
That was pretty good pressure defense on him, and as you said, there was a little carelessness involved also. He was holding the ball carelessly and looking at the defense, and the defense was looking right at that ball.
With a two-point lead, it will be Eastern Illinois' ball. So the Skyhawks with five turnovers and three here in this stretch. UT Martin's just one of their last five shots, three turnovers in the last 2.5 minutes, and have not scored in 2 minutes, 39 seconds. There's a bad pass by Johnston, and then another bad pass by the Skyhawks, and McReynolds has it, 26-24. We have seen a string of turnovers in the last 3 minutes, both teams. McReynolds on the wing. Here's the trap, in trouble on the baseline, finds the open player who scores, Luke Norman.
That was pretty good work to be able to get that ball out of there. I thought he'd have to bounce it out of bounds to reach anyone.
Timeout is taken. It's a media timeout, so we'll take one with the team. 28-24, the Skyhawks have led by as many as seven. Eastern Illinois now up by four with 3:29 remaining. We'll come back with more as you listen to UT. Sleeping on my couch tonight. 3 minutes and 23 seconds to go. The Skyhawks with the ball. Outside Terrence Durham at the top of the key. Left side Kadar Edwards. Skyhawks, one of their last five, have not scored in over 3 minutes. Need a basket on this possession. Three on the shot clock. Anderson falls to the floor and turns it over. Johnston falls to the floor, but a foul against the Skyhawks.
I call that a trip. I couldn't quite see it from here, but Fisher was right over there. He had a better look.
Johnston limping now. Johnston will go to the free throw line. Foul. So Terrence Durham. Alex Anderson just fell down. It was a lateral move there. I don't know. I didn't see that. Again, I don't know. Wasn't a whole lot of contact. Johnston's free throw is good. Skyhawks are down five. Eastern Illinois opened the game with a pair of threes to lead 6-0, and they could match that 6-point lead with a free throw here, up 29-24. Cornell Johnston from St. Louis, Missouri. Casey Tisson checks back in. Pass coming into Durham from Tamon Howard. 3 minutes on the clock. 30-24 our score. Miles Taylor on the outside. Bad pass again. UT Martin has turned it over 8 times. Johnston thought about that 3. Goes to the middle of the floor. Now they'll work it down in the paint. Kulikowski pivoting. Kick out to McReynolds. McReynolds goes baseline. Out to Johnston for 3. Left wing. Misses short. Rebound. Kadar Edwards gets tangled up with Miles Taylor, and Tamon Howard gets the rebound. Here's Mobley with it. Skyhawks down by 6. Have not scored in 4 minutes. Tamon forces one inside and finishes off the glass. It's a 4-point game.
Tamon did a great job that time of making a good fake to the baseline and then pivoting back to the top and banking it off the board.
30-26 the score. 2:03 remaining. First half, Eastern Illinois with the ball. Sean Blackman is in there again. Out to Johnston. Johnston on the right wing. Back in Blackman. Blackman over Howard hits it. And the lead back to 6 for the Panthers.
Needless to say, Johnson leads the team in assists. Boy, he can find the open guy. He's so small, he's got a different angle of view.
He does. He has 5 assists already in this one. Tamon Howard with the jumper from 15. It's good. And here's the stretch. We've seen this throughout the season. When UT Martin struggles, sometimes Tamon Howard can just take over offensively. And a timeout taken by Coach Jay Spoonhauer.
Jay's not going to, with 1:22 left, he's not going to let this lead get away.
It's 32-28. The Skyhawks down by 4. Starting the second half, the Skyhawks have the ball, trailing Eastern Illinois 39-30. Alex Anderson to Terrence Durham inside. Miles Taylor. Taylor goes up and misses. Got the rebound. Hits the floor hard. And Cornell Johnston comes. Anderson scores, and it's a double-digit 11-point lead.
Anderson has come back off of that brief injury and has really showed some real life here.
Trey Anderson with 6 points now. To the basket, Terrence Durham scores, getting it back to 9. And we're seeing some offensive output from Durham. That's his 8th point of the game. He's 3-for-5 from the field. Johnston to Tucson. Skyhawks were down by 17 against Austin Peay, came back and won that game Saturday. UT Martin has won 5 games in a row now, and Eastern Illinois falling in their last 2 matchups. Tucson for 3 over Durham. No rebound goes out, and it is Johnston who tried to save it. Coach Troyer catches him over the sideline and pats him on the back.
Thought he was going to pick him up for a minute.
He could. I was talking with Coach Troyer in the pregame about Johnston. I said, he's the smallest, one of the smallest guys in the OVC. And Coach Troyer said, yeah, but he's a beast. You don't understand all the things that he can do.
Well, he certainly has proved that so far in the first half. Boy, with his assists and his scoring and his ability against our press.
You hear this term in boxing all the time, but pound for pound, he might be one of the toughest guys in the conference. Here's a foul. This one goes against Eastern Illinois. It's just weird with basketball. Cal, you know this. The little guys stand out and the really big guys stand out.
That's right.
You kind of, as a fan, your eyes gravitate.
And you win with those guys that are in between.
That's exactly right. Yeah. Well said. Terrence Durham throws it to Tamon Howard. Howard on the right side. Fadeaway shot. No good. Rebound. Kadar Edwards back up. No. Rebound tipped. Eastern Illinois has it. Coach Schroyer wanted a foul. Johnston threw it away. Kadar Edwards to Alex Anderson. The lob to Howard. Alley-oop time. It's a 7-point game.
Durham tipped that ball away from a dribbling Cornell when he came down there. It looked like he threw it away, but he actually tipped it from behind him and put it in the air.
Another tip, and the Skyhawks have it to Terrence Durham, who finishes. And it's a 5-point game, 4 unanswered, and UT Martin makes a run here to to start the second half. And the alley-oop dunk to Tamond Howard got the crowd into it here at the Elam Center. Anderson has it for Eastern Illinois. Kicks it out, McReynolds for three. That quiets the crowd. And the lead is back to eight. 44-36 our score. Eastern Illinois the lead. UT Martin the basketball. 17 minutes, 23 seconds to go. Tamond Howard kicks it out. Now the pass over to Terrence. Going to get to Alex Anderson. Anderson with a bounce pass or a forward pass to Miles Taylor. Back to Anderson down on the baseline. Alex kicks it out to Tamond Howard for three. Straight away short. Barely caught the front of the rim. McReynolds with the rebound. Over to Johnston. Left wing, Anderson. Anderson drives, one-handed shot off balance, no good. Rebound Skyhawks. Durham to Anderson. Anderson fakes, one way goes the other, shoots and hits.
Boy, Anderson can get that ball away so quickly. He gets up in the air fast, and then he gets that ball out of his hand so quick.
Skyhawks trim it to six. Eastern Illinois with a ball. McReynolds to Tisson for three. Over Durham, hits another one. The freshman can flat out shoot.
Yeah, he's heading for that title.
The lead is at nine.
That's his sixth goal right now, I believe.
It was 12 points and 4 3-pointers. Terrence Durham to the basket, off balance, no good. Coach Schroyer begging for a foul. Steal, Alex Anderson for the Skyhawks. To Miles Taylor to the basket with a left hand, offensive foul. And the freshman, Tisson, took the charge. That's the first on Miles. There was a change in a foul in the first half also, as we watched the OVC Digital Network replay. And he was leaning a little bit, but Tisson was there, and Miles Taylor took it to the basket. 47-38. The Eastern Illinois lead is at nine, and even though UT Martin has made this charge, the Panthers still have the lead and could extend it to double digits with a basket here. Johnston to McReynolds. Down on the baseline, Riley. Back to McReynolds, over to Johnston. There's a baseline move back inside. A foul. The shot is good from A.J. Riley.
Boy, that was pretty good passing inside. We were defensing pretty well, but they threw some very good passes inside to be able to get that shot off, and it was a difficult shot to begin with.
Miles Taylor, a junior from Starkville, Mississippi. Jacoby Mobley. 49-38 the score, and the Skyhawks, Cal, made a run, and even with that run, after cutting it to five, trailed by 11. That says a lot about Eastern Illinois.
Well, I'll tell you what, they've hit some timely goals, and they've usually taken time out to try to stop our runs.
And the free throw is no good. Missing that one was A.J. Riley. And the Skyhawks made that move to get it back to five with good defense, forcing turnovers and scoring in transition. Kadar Edwards on the left side. Bounce pass going to Tamond Howard. Howard faces the basket, works his way in, kicks it out to Terrence Durham, fakes the three. Back to Tamond. Tamond at the free throw line, drives in, kicks out. Edwards for three. Kadar missed it. Rebound, Tamond Howard. Howard back in and scores. He just forced his way in and finished.
And there were two Eastern Illinois players on the floor after he got through with that shot.
They were in the restricted area, so they couldn't take the charge. Riley blocked by Tamond Howard, who gets it back. That was a Bill Russell block shot right there. And Alex Anderson faked the three, kicks it out to Durham, who throws a bad pass. Last touch by Demetrius McReynolds, and that will go back to the Skyhawks. 49-40 the score. UT Martin down nine with the ball. Lots of time left. 14 minutes, 44 seconds. As these two teams battling the Ohio Valley Conference West. Inside, Miles Taylor scores. And it's
that occurred, Chris, like I was talking about earlier. This bunch on the floor, they're switching off of him, and so he ended up with a smaller player. He just turned around and put it in.
Crowd chanting defense. Riley goes inside and misses. Skyhawk rebound. So UT Martin's trimmed it to seven with the ball. Kadar Edwards with a crazy move that's good and scores. Cal, you're the color commentator. Describe that one.
I'll tell you what, that looked like somebody was just getting ready to put a hula hoop around his hips when he jumped in the air to get that shot off. Boy, oh boy, that was a great play.
That was a little bit out of control. He really almost, I don't even know how to describe, he looked like a windmill, kind of the way he goes up. And I mean, he looked like he left too early and was not going to make it to the basket. And then with the windmill move to elude the defender, banks it in.
He must have some kind of a switch in there or something. When he leaves too early, he just throws the switch, says, I need to stay up a little bit longer, please.
Levitate. Kadar finishes that one to make it 49-45. And the Skyhawk lineup now with Mobley, Anderson, Kadar Edwards, Miles Taylor, and Durham. Eastern Illinois has McReynolds, Johnston, Riley, Filigowski, and Norman in the game. Johnston at the point with it. Skyhawks on a 7-0 run now and have hit their last three shots.
And now we've dropped back into a zone.
And Anderson hits a 17-footer. That's Trey Anderson giving Eastern Illinois a 6-point lead. 13 minutes, 47 seconds to go. The Skyhawks with it down by six. Terrence Durham goes back to the middle of the floor. Throws it left wing. Anderson now to Mobley inside. Miles. Kick out. Durham for three straight away. Bang! Cuts it in half on the Zaxby's three. UT Martin trails by three. Coach Schroyer telling the crowd to get up. Anderson going back to the basket and puts it in.
Anderson is a totally different player this half. Boy, oh boy. That was a tough move on the dead move and using that left hand to bank it off the board.
You had to go through Miles Taylor. And a foul against Eastern Illinois. That'll be their third team foul. Norman picks it up. Anderson has 10. McReynolds with 13. They're two players with double digits. The Skyhawks have 13 from Tamon, 13 from Terrence Durham, which is uncharacteristic. And Miles has 10. And Terrence can score. Terrence just doesn't shoot very often. In this game, he's 5 of 8 from the field and 3 of 4 from three-point range. Mobley to Edwards. Skyhawks down 5. Edwards a kick out. Durham again for 3. Missed that one strong. Rebound tipped. Mobley saves it in. And the Eastern Illinois player, I thought, committed a foul. Goes into the sideline there. And took out half of our assistant coaches. Coach Jermaine Johnson on the floor. Flipped backwards in his chair. And that foul was on Norman, his third. Because Norman had Mobley by the jersey when he fell to the floor.
Well, that was a matter of survival right then. I mean, he had his back going and going right into the chairs and the coaches.
Cal, if there's not a foul and he's, you know, on top of a couple of our assistant coaches over on the sideline with a chair on top of him, here's a turnover. I guess the play continues and the Skyhawks would have numbers.
Sure, if there wasn't a foul call right there, that ball would have been in play going down the floor. Sure would.
Another foul, this one on the Skyhawks against Terrence Durham. It's gotten, the intensity level has increased and the physical nature of the game has also increased. And Durham committing that foul. One of the managers, I think, taking care of the perspiration over on the sideline, hash mark in front court. Terrence Durham goes out, Tamon Howard gets back in. 12 and a half remaining, 53-48 the score. The Skyhawks down by 5. Eastern Illinois, the lead in the ball. Riley on the left wing. Top of the key, Johnston. UT Martin in the zone. Back to Riley. Tipped away. And in the passing lane, Kadar Edwards stole it. The ball knocked away by Trey Anderson, and Mobley gets it back in backcourt. Mobley guarded by Johnston. That's a good matchup right there. Mobley got the best of it, takes it to the basket and lost it. Lost the ball out of bounds. UT Martin has turned it over 11 times.
Nard did a great job of being able to deflect that pass to give us that opportunity down here. We didn't take advantage of it. We need to get an opening here. We need to get a good run going and open up a little lead, but we have a little room to breathe because they've done pretty well in some of the close games.
Yeah, without a doubt, this is, you know, similar kind of to what we saw at Eastern Illinois with Eastern Illinois closing strong, although there's a lot of time left. 11 minutes, 43 seconds to go in the steal, but a late, late whistle.
Well, they beat Moorhead by two, mm-hmm. and they beat Austin Peay by one on their court. So they're a very good late game play team.
Miles Taylor commits the foul, and that stops the clock with 11:41 remaining. Eastern Illinois will have it when we return. It's the rebounding is a key. Here's where we are now, 20-19. The Skyhawks with a one rebound advantage. But Eastern Illinois shooting the ball better at 53%, 19 of 36. Meanwhile, the Skyhawks 47% at 18 of 38. And then from three-point range, Eastern Illinois 9 of 17. UT Martin is 5 of 15. Eastern Illinois on the inbounds play. Tisson shoots a baseline shot and hits. He can shoot. And he has 14 points now.
You know, what's impressed me about that freshman kid is he hasn't taken any bad shots. He mm-hmm. did a good job on the fake right then and got his feet planted and knocked that ball down.
No, he's let the offense come to him, that's for sure. And it has come to him several times. Inside, Tamon Howard, an unlikely shot there around Trey Anderson. I don't know how he got it in there, and he's fouled. That was another strong up-and-under move by the UT Martin senior.
He actually put that ball around the defender before he released it. Watch.
Yeah, that was a fantastic play there by Tamon Howard. And you know, Cal, you see all the great ones. Great concentration. Never took his ball or his eye off of the basket.
Right.
Never. Kept his balance in the air and kept his eye on the prize. Mobley goes out. Barist comes in. Coach Schroyer talking to Mobley. Pass coming into Tisson. Eleven minutes and 7 seconds to go at the Elam Center. UT Martin has cut it to four. Tisson to Trey Anderson. Out to Kuligowski. One more pass. Johnston. Johnston to Tisson. He's had the hot hand. Misses the three, but he's fouled by Kadar Edwards. And Cal savvy enough to sell that foul. And he'll go to the free throw line to shoot three.
You were talking about earlier, Chris, about the four-point mm-hmm. attempts. That's a typical. If that ball was just a shade off of being down in that goal, it just hit the back of the rim. That would have been a four-pointer. But you notice what attracted it, and the reason you're seeing more is exactly what the defense is doing. Here's a guy with a hot hand. Mm-hmm. We've got to shut him down, and you overplay him, and you put him at the line for three.
Coach Royer talking to Kadar now. He goes out of the game. Richard Lee coming in. Tisson's hit two free throws. We'll get another one here for the hat trick from the charity stripe. Missed that one. And foul on the rebound going against Eastern Illinois. That's their sixth team foul. Kuligowski with the foul. His second. Is that right? No, his first. Norman has three for Eastern Illinois, and then UT Martin has Mobley with three and Miles Taylor with three. Miles inside strong. It falls in, and he's fouled. 57-53. It's a four-point game. 10 minutes, 46 seconds to go. Miles really putting it on in this one. That's his 12th point. And Johnston goes out. Norman back in.
We said we're going to have some of that help from Miles this half to be able to get that thing back. And he certainly came through on that shot.
Missed the free throw. Boy, this is turning into a game similar as it was in Eastern Illinois, where the teams just went back and forth, although Eastern Illinois has gotten a little bit of separation here. And even though the Skyhawks are battling, they cannot get the lead back. Nice up and under move, no good. Blackman misses it. Rebound, UT Martin. Outlet to Barist. Barist kicks it to Alex Anderson. With Lee, Miles, Barist, and Howard. It's a lineup we've not seen much of. And Richard Lee for three, hits one. And the Skyhawks trail by one on the Richard Lee three. Now that's a play we saw from Richard Lee early in the season. Kuligowski to Tyson. Over to Norman. Right side, McReynolds. And Coach Spoonhauer doesn't like what he sees, so he calls a timeout. We'll take a timeout. 9 minutes, 49 seconds to go at the Elam Center. And the Skyhawks have cut it to one. Hall of Fame coach Cal Luther. And the Skyhawks have made a move. Eastern Illinois with a basketball. UT Martin down by one. The crowd chanting defense on their feet here. McReynolds has it left wing. Kicks it out. Long three-point attempt. Kuligowski hits it. And the lead is back at four for the Eastern Illinois Panthers.
We get right up to a one-point difference in the ball game, and a couple of times now they've come back and put that three down.
Richard Lee on the left wing, inside to Tamon, has Johnson on him, goes up, and it rolls off the side of the iron. Rebound Blackman. Tamon recognized the mismatch there with the smaller guard on him. Eastern Illinois with the basketball, 9 minutes to go. McReynolds drives, stops on the baseline to Kuligowski. Back to McReynolds. Left wing Johnson. Right side turnover, and the Skyhawks will have it. Not only did Norman not handle the pass, he ran over his coach.
Now that's something that'll get you in trouble in a hurry.
You never throw the pass away and miss the player and hit the coach.
Or
you
that's
never,
right.
There's a certain, you don't want to turn it over right in front of coach.
Throw it at one of the radio announcers, but don't do that.
60-56 the score. And Tyson gets in there. Norman goes out. The Skyhawks will have it. Here's the lineup. Again, not what you would expect with Vareist in there. Tamon Howard, Richard Lee, Miles Taylor, and Alex Anderson. This is the group that's made the run, though, to cut it to one. Down by four now. Vareist on the wing. Out to Alex Anderson. Here's Richard Lee. Lee on the right wing. Lee gets a screen from Howard. Picks up his dribble. Throws it to Anderson. Shot clock at nine. Back over to Richard Lee for three. Missed it strong. Rebound Miles Taylor. Out to Anderson. Bounce pass to Howard. With the freshman on him, Tamon goes in. Feeds it to Miles Taylor. Scores. And is fouled by Patrick Muldoon. And if Richard Lee's three didn't fall, Miles Taylor has a chance to make one the old-fashioned way. 8 minutes and 21 seconds remaining.
Miles missed his last free throw up here. He'll make this one.
Got it. One-point game again. And the Skyhawks need a stop here. The crowd chanting defense. And a backcourt foul on Vareist. And that is UT Martin's sixth team foul. Eastern Illinois with 18 fouls. And both teams will be in the bonus for the rest of the second half. Inbounding the ball, it is Trey Anderson getting it to Cornell Johnston, the sophomore point guard. Johnston on the Skyhawk logo. Dribbles. Bounce pass to Trey Anderson at the free throw line, and Vareist fouled him. And that's free throws now for Trey Anderson. Cal, the help defense came over. It was a touch foul, but I think there was some contact.
Yeah, there was some contact, all right, but you're right. It really was one of those that did not affect the game in any way, shape, or form, except if the official.
Anderson is not a great free throw shooter. He's 66% on the season. He's 2 for 2 in this game. The free throw is good.
Well, we'll see how good of a clutch free throw shooter he is.
Right. And it's 61-59. Now the EIU lead is at 2. The second free throw for Trey Anderson. Got them both. Anderson, the senior. And the Skyhawks down by 3 again at 62-59. 7 minutes, 58 seconds remaining. We'll get a media timeout, the next dead ball. Richard Lee still in there for UT Martin. Alex Anderson. Anderson feeds it in the corner. Vareist goes strong to the glass and misses. Rebound to Mon Howard. Saves it to Richard Lee. Great effort by Howard. Anderson for the tie. Missed the three. Rebound. Trey Anderson. Anderson ahead of the pack. Goes all the way to the basket. And the travel is called That would have been quite the play. Patrick Muldoon looks at the official and shakes his head no. Cal, I don't know. Did you see a travel in there?
I did not see a travel on that one, but yeah. I'll certainly accept
we'll
it.
We'll take it, though. Timeout. We'll take a timeout. 7 minutes, 33 seconds. And the Skyhawks here, 62-59, trailed by three. There's the play from Anderson. Richard Lee, the Skyhawk, called the charge, or called the travel, and UT Martin got the turnover. I didn't see it. We watched the replay, Cal.
I just watched it. There was no travel.
And Eastern Illinois, 14 turnovers. UT Martin's turned it over 11 times, so Skyhawks may catch a break on that one. Jalen Vareist with it for UT Martin. Vareist on the left wing. Throws it to Tamon Howard. Howard at the top of the key. Howard drives in, throws it out to Alex Anderson.
They're going to work hard right now to get it to Miles down there.
Back to Tamon, back to Alex, back to Tamon. Corner pass, Richard Lee for three, no good. Rebound, out of bounds, Eastern Illinois basketball. 16 for Tucson leads the way for Eastern Illinois. UT Martin has 16 for Tamon Howard. Both teams have three players in double digits. So a three-point lead, and Eastern Illinois has the ball. Johnston guarded by Vareist. A lot of players for the blue and orange contributing in this one, coming off the bench and playing. Out to Muldoon. Inside Trey Anderson, backing down Richard Lee. Turnaround shot, no good. Rebound to Mon Howard. Skyhawks with it, down by three. Alex Anderson cannot handle the outlet pass, and it goes out of bounds.
Mon just threw that ball a little bit out of reach. I mean, it was a good idea, and it would have been a great situation, but he just had it too far out of reach to be able to catch up with it.
Johnston back in backcourt. Vareist on him. Has 4 seconds to get across the timeline and does. Vareist is not going to guard him too closely with both teams being in the bonus. Johnston on the wing to Muldoon. Back to Johnston. Left side, the freshman Tisson. Here's Johnston. Seven on the shot clock. Johnston for three. The southpaw hits one. And that doubles up the lead now. A 6-point advantage for Eastern Illinois.
We need that breakaway. We need that breakaway.
65-59. The Skyhawks trailing with the ball. 6 minutes remaining. Richard Lee to Alex Anderson. Bounce pass to Tamon Howard. Howard takes Anderson to the basket. The reverse is good and the foul. And Tamon Howard is putting together a solid game. His 18th point.
We've got both Tamon and Miles down there on either side of the lane. And we've found an Achilles heel right there. If we can really capitalize on it here.
Tamon Howard has hit all three of his free throws. 65-61 the score as the Elam center gets quiet. Free throw is good. Kuligowski checks back in. And Muldoon goes out of the game. The lineup for UT Martin still Lee, Anderson, Howard, Taylor, Vareist. And Eastern Illinois has the ball in backcourt. Johnston with the dribble. In the game with Anderson, Kuligowski, McReynolds, and Tisson. Twelve on the shot clock. McReynolds on the baseline. The shot is up. No good. Rebound. Richard Lee was out of bounds when he got the board. But it will be, and I'm not really sure how, it will be Skyhawk basketball. Not a foul. Anderson not too happy. Yeah, Trey Anderson still questioning that. 65-62. UT Martin with the ball could tie with a three-point play here. As Eastern Illinois is led here throughout the second half. Richard Lee bouncing it to Alex Anderson for the tie. Missed it. Rebound. Stick back is no good. Tamon Howard. And a fight for the loose ball. Eastern Illinois has it. Trey Anderson on a breakaway. Vareist is there. Anderson finishes anyway. And it is a 5-point Panther lead.
That was a key possession right there. Had a chance to really stretch it out if we could have got a score and got some momentum going.
Coach Schroyer takes a timeout, a 30-second timeout with 4 minutes and 54 seconds remaining. with that, we'll keep it here. If you're looking for a place to meet for good times and a great meal before or after the game, La Cabana Mexican Restaurant is the place. They're in historic downtown Mohawk. Italian and benefits of participating in the ROTC that's coming up at the half with Bud Grimes. 32-28 our score. Eastern Illinois with it after Coach Spoonauer took that timeout. 24 on the shot clock. Johnston has it. The point guard listed at 5'7", 150. McReynolds double clutches over Mobley, misses, but will go to the free throw line to shoot two. And that's three on Jacoby. McReynolds from the free throw line, 87% on the season. 6 points in this game, has not been to the line, has two rebounds and an assist. The free throw is good. The lead is at five. Mobley goes out. Alex Anderson in. Patrick Muldoon in there as Kulikowski goes out. Luke Norman will also check in. Eastern Illinois' second free throw is good. 34-28. The lead is at six. Skyhawks trail with the ball. Tamon Howard into Terrence Durham. Howard's been the focal point offensively of late. 9 points now in the game. Howard has the top of the key. Takes it in. Kicks it out to Alex Anderson. Sets a screen for Anderson on the left wing. Here's Miles Taylor. Taylor kick out. Kadar Edwards for three. Missed it strong. Rebound. Tamon Howard couldn't hold on to it. It was in his hands. Marshawn Blackman gets the board. Tucson fakes one, throws it to Johnston. Eastern Illinois with a ball and a six-point lead, their biggest of the game. Back out, Tucson, three, good, over Anderson. The Panther lead is at nine. 37-28, where did this come from, Cal?
Well, Tucson now, is, as I said, is working on trying to be the freshman with the most three-pointers in a given season. He's off to a pretty good start here. He's 3 for 5 right now.
Miles Taylor fouled. Marshawn Blackman with a foul put Miles Taylor at the free throw line. Miles Taylor, the free throw shooter in his career, has made 510 coming into this game. And a strong move there by Miles puts him at the charity stripe. The free throw is good. 79% on the season. Skyhawks cut it to eight with Demetrius McReynolds coming back in. Marshawn Blackman going out. Coach Spoonauer making a lot of changes here late in the half. And Coach Heath Schroyer is going to make a change or two. Richard Lee set to check in. Second free throw is good. It's a 7-point game. And Jalen Barist checks in. It's been a little while since we've seen Jalen. Has not played in each of the last four games. Barista, strong, pesky defender out there guarding Johnston.
Boy, Johnston is just a blur when he turns it on. Boy, oh boy, he's quick.
McReynolds at the free throw line. Turnaround shot over Lee. Hits it at the buzzer. And the score now 39-30. The Skyhawks are down by nine at the half. Coming up, the McDonald's halftime show. Cal and I will look back at the...
Right. Well, I'll tell you what, with the way they're playing, the way Eastern Illinois has been playing, coming back each time we've tried to make a run, it's certainly not very comfortable just sitting there on a one-point lead.
Tamon Howard at the free throw line. These two teams played earlier this season at the Lance Arena. Skyhawks lost that one 82-74. UT Martin has not lost a game since then, winning five in a row. And Tamon Howard at the charity stripe. The free throw is bouncing in. It was a flat free throw spinning around. It goes, and the Skyhawks lead by two. And Jalen Barist commits a backcourt foul. Cal, I have a feeling that this game is going to come down to free throws because both teams are in the bonus. And the officials are calling it closely, and they have throughout the second half.
They're actually calling a few that aren't even there.
Muldoon goes out. And Petrowski checks back in, the 6'11 senior. Johnston at the line, 67%. It's a 1-1, and it rattles around and goes. The Skyhawk lead is cut to 169-68.
I'm sorry to say, but it's probably going to be tied up here in a couple seconds.
The lefty missed that one. It spins up. Yep. Skyhawks have it with a one-point lead. UT Martin's head basketball coach Heath Schroyer calls out the play. Brees to Miles Taylor. Faked the shot. Throws it inside to Tamon Howard. Howard with a turnaround left-handed shot. Foul. And Howard will go to the free throw line. You know, Cal, if the officials are going to call it like that, you just got to post him up and let him go to the basket.
Post him up. Yeah. You sure have.
And why not?
Miles was anxious to throw that ball in there to Howard, and in doing so, he shuffled his feet beforehand. I thought, sure, they're so focused on calling a foul, they didn't look at the foot motion.
Free throw is good. And the one thing that Miles had Petrowski on him, so it's important for Miles to keep Petrowski away from the basket because
right.
He's 6'11". 70-68, Skyhawks with a two-point lead. And Tamon Howard goes back to the charity stripe. Tamon with 23 points, the reigning OVC player of the week. The second free throw is good. And the Skyhawk lead is at 3. So, again, if it's a free throw shooting contest and Johnston made 1 of 2, Tamon Howard made both of his. You watch this down the stretch, and the team that shoots the best from the charity stripe will put themselves in good position in this one. Petrowski, turnaround hook shot, no good. Rebound, Skyhawks. And then Miles Taylor panicked and threw it away. UT Martin has turned it over 13 times. And it was a battle in there for that rebound.
You know, in this five-game stretch when we've won, I think that might be high.
Turnovers?
Yes,
yeah,
we've kept our turnovers down.
Yeah, down in single digits some games. Now, even with the 13 turnovers, Eastern Illinois has turned it over 14 times. Eastern Illinois has it down by 3. McReynolds goes in. Kicks it out 3. No good. Missing that one. Johnston. And the ball goes out of bounds. Saved by Miles Taylor, who gets it to Mobley. Mobley to Tamon Howard. Fakes the shot, shoots the jumper, and hits it. And the Skyhawks lead it by 5. And this Elam Center crowd is as excited as I've heard them in a long time.
That changes the picture right there. Coach is getting after the crowd like he's mad at him. You know, I got to give him a response when that takes place.
73-68, the fans are making some noise now.
Obviously, the gun people have come in here strong because there's not been a gun in sight tonight. I'm throwing up the
t-shirts.
This is strictly just throwing lined up and throw one.
With the basketball, Cornell Johnston. Getting it to Anderson. Anderson drives in on Miles Taylor. Misses, but Miles will be called for the foul with 2:14 to go. And to the free throw line, Eastern Illinois. That's 4 on Miles.
Well, you're right. You're right on the way they're calling these fouls, Chris.
My gosh.
I mean, he didn't even have his hands up in that area.
And, Cal, that you have to call it that way now to be consistent with what you've done
the entire game. Exactly.
And that's the one thing I think you ask from officials, the free throw is good, is that consistency. And they are being consistent. And the whistles are being blown. Second free throw for Anderson is good. He nets a pair. And the Skyhawk lead is at 3, 73-70. As the Panther senior, Trey Anderson, hit 2 free throws. 2:07 to go. UT Martin with a lead in the ball.
Now they're going to get it to Miles.
Howard goes in to Miles Taylor. Offensive foul. Tamon Howard a bit out of control as he's taking it to the basket.
Yep.
And 2 Eastern Illinois players on the floor. 1 is A.J. Riley. And that's the 3rd on Tamon. No free throws here, though. It being a player control foul. Trey Anderson is shaken up. And the officials taking care of some perspiration on the floor there underneath the basket in backcourt. That'll give Anderson a little bit to recover. 73-70, the Skyhawks with a three-point lead. 2 minutes remaining. Elam Center. Eastern Illinois schedule. Only two games remaining at Southeast Missouri. And then at home with Murray State. Here's McReynolds for three. A big one that ties it up at 73 apiece.
As I mentioned, Chris, they've been very tough on the road with these close games. Beat Moorhead 2, beat Austin Peay 1.
A timeout is taken. We'll keep it here with a minute 45 remaining. I believe it's a 30-second timeout. 70. Both of these teams have had their share of close games. But this is the kind of game, if it goes to overtime, you're not at all surprised. 73-73. Skyhawks have the ball with a minute 45 to go. And Tamon Howard getting it into Alex Anderson. In the game with Miles Taylor, Jacoby Mobley, and Richard Lee. McReynolds, Johnston, Tyson Riley, and Trey Anderson in for Coach Spoonhour.
Now they got it.
Mobley for three. Missed it. Rebound Eastern Illinois. Anderson coming down for the Panthers. Both teams in the double bonus. A minute 23 remaining. Still tied. McReynolds to Anderson. Here's Riley. Riley in the paint. And a foul. Offensive foul against Eastern Illinois.
Yes, he dropped his shoulder and went right into him.
The most important part about that possession is the Skyhawks get it back. That's a turnover. And the foul goes on A.J. Riley, his fourth. That was a smart play by Miles Taylor, Cal, to take that charge and not try to block it or defend it with the way the officials are calling it.
That's right.
73-73, Skyhawk ball with a minute 14 to go. Vareist for UT Martin.
Now they've got to get the ball to Miles right now, and that's what they want.
Tamon Howard looking inside to Miles. Not there. Back over to Vareist on the left wing. With a minute remaining, 16 on the shot clock. Vareist back with it.
Now they got it to him.
Miles double clutches and misses. Rebound, Kuligowski. Eastern Illinois with a ball with 49 seconds to go and 25 on the shot clock. Tyson to McReynolds. Back to Tyson. Now to Johnston. Gonna get to Trey Anderson. Corner, Tyson. The freshman almost pulled the trigger there. 9 seconds on the clock. Trey Anderson has it top of the key with Miles on him. Trey drives, goes in, fakes, shoots, misses. Rebound tip, no. Anderson again, no. Skyhawks, Richard Lee gets the rebound. UT Martin has it with 17 seconds to go. Coach Schroyer not taking a timeout. Now he takes the timeout. Stopping the clock with 9.7 seconds remaining. Cal, Eastern Illinois had their chances on that last possession.
Oh, they sure did.
Man.
Not only had a shot that almost fell, got Miles in that position.
Earlier this year, Tamon hit a game winner against James Madison. And here the score is 73-73 with 9.7 seconds remaining. The Skyhawks have it in front court. Mobley, Alex Anderson, Richard Lee, Miles Taylor, and Tamon Howard. Howard has a career-high 26. You expect him to touch the ball, and he gets the inbounds pass. With 8 seconds to go, Cal, I think it's his to win. 5 seconds, four, at the free throw line, spinning inside. Inside, he finds Richard Lee, and he throws it away. And Tamon should have shot that one and threw one pass too
many.
That
was his shot.
To Richard Lee, and Tamon crouching down. Eastern Illinois will have it in backcourt with 0.6 seconds remaining. And Coach Spoonhour will take a timeout to draw a play. Man, to make a pass, a catch, and a shot.
Yep. Or pass it to somebody and let them tip it to a shooter.
Mm-hmm. And inbounding it in backcourt, it will be Kuligowski. You have to go the distance for Eastern Illinois. For the Skyhawks, you cannot foul. Kuligowski throws a home run pass down to, oh my, Demetrius McReynolds, who had the look, Cal, and missed it. I think it would have been good if he hits it.
Oh, yeah. It would have been a good shot. All he had to do is get it high enough on the board.
Demetrius McReynolds caught the ball down on the block in front court from a back court pass and missed it.
Fella, number 33, Miles Taylor. UT Martin is coached by Heath Schroyer. Assistant coaches Anthony Stewart, Jermaine Johnson, John Aiken, DeAndre Walker, and Garner Small.
I'm Chris Brinkley with Coach Cal Luther as the Skyhawks are set to take on Eastern Illinois. And Cal, this is a very good Eastern Illinois team we're playing today.
Yes, it is. And their coach has got some great experience. He's just building a program. He's one of the ranked teams in the country for bringing in the most new players. I think they were ranked second. So he's got a brand new squad in most respects. And he's got some real talent at it. There's some talented freshman kids and some talented junior college kids in the lineup.
And Kadar Edwards going in there. Tamon Howard jumping against Petrowski in the ball. Who's got it? First possession, UT Martin has it. And the Skyhawks will have it with just under 20 minutes on the clock here. 3 seconds ticked off during that first one. Cal, you're right there on that one. And the Skyhawks inbounding it to Mon Howard, getting it to Terrence Durham. Durham over on the right side to Alex. Back to Kadar. Kadar Edwards kicks it out. Alex Anderson for three. Missed it short. Rattles around. No rebound. The smallest man on the floor, Cornell Johnson, gets it. And Cornell, a 5'7 guard from St. Louis, a sophomore. And a foul inside against the Skyhawks. This one goes against Tamon Howard.
Cornell may be one of the smallest guys in the league, but he's got one of the tallest haircuts in the league.
No doubt about it. That makes him a little bit taller, doesn't it? You're welcome. Cal, I got to do some housekeeping over here for just a second.
Shot by Demetrius McReynolds. That's good.
And Demetrius hits that three-pointer with the Skyhawks trailing by three. With the basketball, Terrence Durham now for UT Martin. Terrence gets it over to Alex Anderson, now to Kadar Edwards. Edwards fires and misses. Rebound coming off to Trey Anderson. Right side, Tisson. Out to Trey Anderson. To Cornell Johnston at the Elam Center, the Eastern Illinois in the road blue with the white numbers and the Skyhawks in the home white. Blue numbers trimmed in orange. McReynolds on the outside. Inside Petrowski, six on the shot clock, getting it to Johnston, who shoots the three and connects. And just like that, UT Martin is trailing 6-0.
They start right off and hit the first two shots they attempt, and they're both threes and both deep.
And the Skyhawks 0-for-2 from the field, trailing 6-0, while Eastern Illinois is 2-for-2. Bad pass, and Terrence Durham gets it near midcourt on the Skyhawk logo. Here's a screen from Miles Taylor. Terrence to Tamon Howard. Howard inside. Miles up, fouled, and fouled by Luke Petrowski. Cal, from here, that looked like pretty solid defense.
I was just going to comment. The big guy never gets a break on these deals.
Here's the replay on OVC Digital. And he was leaning forward a little bit.
A little bit was probably the important word right there.
Yeah, and Miles Taylor at the free throw line hits it with the Skyhawks making it 6-1. And the second free throw is good, and UT Martin cuts it to 4, 6-2 now the score. With 18-18 to go. UT Martin showing the full court pressure to Eastern Illinois in backcourt. Petrowski to McReynolds. McReynolds got the hot hand against UT Martin at Lance Arena. Inside pass on the reverse is no good. Anderson misses. And the ball goes out of bounds, but a foul is called.
I think the foul was on Kadar.
Kadar with a foul. Here's a baseline shot that's up and no good. And a foul on the rebound going against McReynolds. stopping the clock with 18:03 to go in the first. That's the team's second foul. Tamon Howard will inbound it in backcourt, getting it to Terrence Durham. Durham guarded by Cornell Johnston. A couple three-pointers in Eastern Illinois is a four-point lead early in this one. Miles Taylor puts down the dribble, takes it right to Petrowski and scores. And the Skyhawks cut it to two.
That's a tough matchup for Petrowski. He's 6'11".
Yeah, Miles is a little bit undersized in there, but has some quickness at 6'7". And he's gotten all four of UT Martin's points here in the early going. Anderson facing the basket from the free throw line. Fadeaway over Miles is no good. Rebound UT Martin's to Mond Howard. Outlet to Durham. Durham getting it to Kadar Edwards. Edwards on the left wing. Throws it inside to Miles Taylor. Taylor kicks it out. Terrence Durham fires a three. Straight away good. And UT Martin has taken the lead now. It's 7-6. Turnover. Eastern Illinois fighting to press. And an offensive foul on Cornell Johnston. What did he do, Cal?
He got his arm out ahead and pushed off on him.
Dribbling with one hand, pushing off with the other.
That's right.
And the Skyhawks will have the ball here with a one-point lead. Terrence Durham on the left wing. And another whistle blown. This away from the ball. It goes against the Skyhawks. Kadar Edwards with the foul. With 17 exactly remaining. And Richard Lee comes in for Kadar Edwards. Lee, the sophomore from Lake Worth, Florida. Really got off to a hot start to begin the season. Has seen his minutes limited of late, averaging 6.6 per game.
We've got six fouls on the board already now for just 3 minutes of play.
Yeah, each team with three. Cornell Johnston trapped in the corner. Eastern Illinois gives it up. Back out to McReynolds. Over to Johnston. Fires it and misses. Rebound Miles Taylor. McReynolds tried to knock it away, but Miles held on to it. Outlet to Tamon Howard. Three-pointer is no good. Rebound McReynolds. Eastern Illinois back with the basketball. Outside Johnston calling out the play. Over to Tisson. Now McReynolds shoots the three and misses everything. Rebound Alex Anderson. And Eastern Illinois cooling off from the field now. Just 2 of 7 after hitting their first two shots. Richard Lee for three. It rattles around and doesn't go. Falls off the iron. Eastern Illinois back with it. 16:07 remaining here. Johnston to Anderson. Left side to Tisson. Johnston on the right wing. Inside Petrowski. Miles Taylor with the steal. Saves it into Richard Lee. Skyhawks on the move. Anderson. UT Martin does not have the numbers. And Eastern Illinois showing the transition defense. Coach Heath Schroyer calling out the set in backcourt there. As you hear him on a crowd mic. Miles Taylor has Petrowski on him again. Works his way inside. Kicks it back out to Terrence Durham. 9 on the shot clock. Terrence drives. Goes all the way in. Kick out to Richard Lee. Fakes the shot. 4 on the shot clock. 3. One-handed shot. Good. And the Skyhawks lead it by 3. Good patience, Cal.
That was very good. And boy, Lee made a very tough shot going directly at the goal and hit nothing but the net.
Anderson kicking it out. McReynolds shoots and hits. And it is a tie game at 9 apiece. Demetrius McReynolds, a 35% three-point shooter on the season. And he has his second three-pointer of the game. 6 points for him, and it's 9-9. Skyhawk basketball with 14:52 remaining in the first half. Terrence Durham for three, left wing, got it. Cal, that barely touched the net.
Yeah, that net stayed still after the ball went through.
You don't see that very often. 12-9 the score. The Skyhawks back down on defense with a three-point lead. Tisson. Now to Anderson. Here's a lob inside. Petrowski goes for the dunk and missed it. The big fella couldn't put it in. 6'11 senior. And a travel. Alex Anderson walks, and the Skyhawks are turning it over for the second time. Turnovers even at 2. We'll take a break. It's 12-9. UT Martin with a 3-point lead. Eastern Illinois with a basketball with 14:20 remaining. And we come back on the UT Martin Skyhawk Sports Net. Out to Tisson. Left side McReynolds for three. Hits it. And he was wide open. The Skyhawks are down by one. 76-75.
McReynolds has really shown some good three-point shooting here, particularly in his second half.
3 minutes, 37 seconds to go. UT Martin in overtime back with it. Tamon Howard hands it to Alex Anderson. Anderson comes over to the corner. Anderson feeds it to Vareist. Inside, Miles Taylor splits a double team, goes up and is fouled. Miles Taylor will shoot free throws.
That's the play coach was looking for.
And the Skyhawks now with back-to-back overtime games. And the last time this happened was in 2006. Let's watch the replay. Miles Taylor just spins right through a double team, hits the free throw. And we're tied at 76 apiece with Mobley coming in for Jalen Vareist. Skyhawks lost in that overtime, the first game, 80-70 to Eastern Illinois. And in the second game on January 14, 2006, beat Moorhead 71-66. In their last overtime game, won over Austin Peay on Saturday. Second free throw is good. UT Martin up by one. On a Mobley three, the Skyhawks won that one 85-84 and are in OT here again 10 years later against Eastern Illinois. Skyhawks with a one-point lead. Trey Anderson has it for the Panthers. Goes in, double team, kicks it out to Mobley. Kadar Edwards has checked in. He's on Mobley. McReynolds shoots a three and misses. Rebound to Mon Howard. Skyhawk basketball with a one-point lead. 2 minutes, 57 seconds to go. It's Mobley, Vareist, Taylor, Howard, and Edwards in for the Skyhawks. McReynolds, Johnston, Tisson, Anderson, and Kuligowski for Eastern Illinois and Coach Spooner.
This is our time where we've got to make that separation.
Here's Kadar Edwards to Jalen Vareist. Vareist puts down the dribble. Vareist takes a two-point attempt and hits it. And the Skyhawks lead by three, 79-76. Johnston with it for Eastern Illinois to Tisson. Back to Johnston. Over to McReynolds. 16 on the shot clock. Eastern Illinois working it around the perimeter. Back to Johnston. Hash mark right side. Here's Anderson at the top of the key. 9 on the shot clock to Johnston. Johnston breaks to the basket. Kicks it out. Long one. Kuligowski misses. Weak side rebound. Howard. There you go, Cal. The Skyhawks have a three-point lead and the ball with under 2 minutes to go. Jalen Vareist to Mobley. You just got to get a good shot here, and if you can score, it's a two-possession lead. Vareist on the left wing. Bounce pass to Tamon Howard. 10 on the shot clock. Howard drives in, goes up, shoots and misses. Rebound, Miles Taylor. Miles fouled. We'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
I think you made the comment earlier in the game, Chris, that this game was going to boil down to free throws.
Yeah.
And this is what we're seeing right now.
And the Skyhawks, Cal, are 19 for 20 from the free throw line.
Unbelievable.
That's amazing. Free throw is good. They're 20 of 21.
Of course, out of that 19, I think 17 or 18 have been.
Miles is 12 Miles of 13, I think, or 11 of 12. No, he's 12 of 13. Free throw is good. Yeah. Skyhawks lead it by 5, 81-76 with a minute 38 to go. Johnston in backcourt for Eastern Illinois passes the timeline. Guarded by Vareist, throws it to Anderson. 90 seconds to go. Eastern Illinois not panicking. Taking their time on the possession. Anderson shoots a two-pointer and misses. Rebound, Vareist. And the Skyhawks have control of this game, leading 81-76, up 5 with a minute 15 to go and the ball. And Johnston falls to the floor. Vareist hits Howard, and Howard travels. And that's a weird one because Johnston fell down. Vareist sped up the offense. It led to the turnover, so it actually benefited Eastern Illinois.
That's right.
Oddly enough.
That was a weird set of events right there.
Minute 9 to go. Eastern Illinois back with the ball. UT Martin with a 5-point lead. Tisson throwing it to A.J. Riley. Riley double clutches and hits it. And the lead is cut to 3. Skyhawks 81-78. The ball in the lead. 54 seconds to go. Now all Eastern Illinois has to do is get one stop. 49 seconds to go, and they have a chance to tie on a 3-point play. Vareist on the wing, 18 on the shot clock. Vareist taking it to the basket, kicks it out to Kadar Edwards. Loose, Kadar fumbles it, gets it back. Throws a dangerous pass to Mobley for three. He hits it. Jacoby Mobley with two games.
I was going to say, that looks like a replay of the Austin Peay game, doesn't it?
He's hit shots from the right wing. Riley for three for EIU. He hits it, and it's a three-point game. Cal, I feel like an Martin in backcourt with Tamon Howard. Anderson is in there. Mobley. Bariste. And Miles Taylor. And Howard will inbound it to Mobley. Mobley getting it to Bariste. Bariste in backcourt throws it to Howard, and he's fouled. 21.9 seconds to go. Now, Bariste has not spent a lot of time at the free throw line. I've got to go to the overall stats, as a matter of fact, just to see. Now, he's seen limited minutes of late. He is 9 for 13 from the free throw line on the season. So 69%, he's made 9 of 13 attempts. It's his chance to really put the separation together needed to win this game. Jalen Bariste, the junior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. He's seen a lot of playing time here in this second half and overtime period. 21.9 seconds remaining. The Skyhawks lead it by three. As the Elam Center crowd gets quiet, Bariste at the free throw line hits it. Cal, he looked pretty cool up there to me.
He did. He looked very relaxed. Had good rhythm on his shot. The difference is now 4 points.
85-81, and Bariste goes back to the charity stripe. Skyhawks leading it by four. The Bariste free throw is spinning out. Rebound Eastern Illinois. 20 seconds to go. They need to score in a hurry. Trey Anderson behind the back goes in, kicks it out, and Johnston for three misses it. Rebound. Mobley looked like he was fouled in there, and he was. And the foul goes against Eastern Illinois on the rebound. Coach Spoonauer politely disagrees. And the Skyhawks will go to the free throw line. And Cal, that may do it with 11.7 seconds remaining.
I think that will do it.
I assume Mobley will go to the charity stripe. So, Cal, your teams went to back-to-back-to-back overtimes. I don't want another one Saturday against SAU Edwardsville. I mean, if that's what it takes to win the game, that's fine, but I'd rather win it in regulation.
Well, I can't blame you for that.
Yeah.
Because it really is.
It's exhausting.
Look what it's done to me.
It's exhausting. Mobley at the free throw line hits it.
I didn't have any of these wrinkles before that time.
I knew something was different. I knew that. The Skyhawks lead it by five on the Mobley free throw. And the second free throw, no good. Rebound Eastern Illinois. Trey Anderson coming down for the Panthers. Anderson with a quick three with 6 seconds to go. He connects. And it's a two-point game at 86-84. UT Martin will inbound it to Kadar Edwards, back to Howard. Howard is fouled with 3.4 seconds to go. And Cal, look, my hair is getting grayer by the second. I just keep it short to hide the gray.
I want to tell you what, there's a product out right now that saved me.
Is it what Walt Frazier and Keith Hernandez
use? It's called Just for Men.
Just for Men, that's right. Tamon Howard will go to the free throw line with the Skyhawks leading it by two, 86-84. Howard has had a career game, 28 points, career high, 7 of 7 from the free throw line. And goes to the charity stripe here. The free throw is good. Now, Cal, as much as we joke here, let's give Eastern Illinois a ton of credit. They have played a tremendous game and really had a chance to win it at the end of regulation. Should have won it.
With all the new players they have and everything, to go on a road and play a good ball club like we have, they've really shown a lot of guts.
Howard misses the free throw. Rebound McReynolds, 2 seconds to go. And he'll shoot at the buzzer. But not enough. The Skyhawks win this one, 87-84. Coach Heath Schroyer will join us on our weekly County Motors postgame report. As UT Martin wins this game over the Eastern Illinois Panthers. That will create some separation from the two schools. Eastern Illinois is 7-7 now in Ohio Valley Conference play. And the Skyhawks go to 8-5. And UT Martin will be behind Murray State in the standings with a chance to play Murray the last game of the season. And Coach Heath Schroyer joining us here on the weekly County Motors postgame report as the coach makes his way over. That was big.